Good morning, Nevada, and all our neighboring states. I'm Peter Lycopoulos, and hey, I'm back, and this is the September 1st, 2012 edition of Rural Nevada Today, brought to you by the Dairy Farmers of Southern Nevada. I'd like to start out by thanking Daryl for filling in for me. As always, he did a great job, and I really appreciate him coming in here and taking care of business while I was gone. Now, today, we got a special celebration going on today. Today is our 14th anniversary. It was on a Saturday morning back in 1998 on KLAV. Yeah, the old Outdoor Adventure Show started. My first guest was Jeff Schneider from the division, then the Division of Wildlife. And I'll tell you what, a lot's happened in the past 14 years, and I hope that we've kept up with the changes. Mostly, I hope we've kept you entertained and looking forward to another 14 years. And today also, my anniversary coincides with the dove season opener. So we're going to do something. Well, we're going to do a couple of things today. But one of the things that we're going to do is anybody who calls in today, the first person, not anybody, the first person who calls in today to give me a report, what they're seeing so far this morning, you get either a topographical map or you get a pocket knife, one or the other. The second caller who calls in and tells me what's going on with their hunt and gets what the first guy didn't take, okay? And then we'll have a trivia question as always. And I'll tell you what, with September comes the greatest time of the year. NFL football starts in earnest. The hunt season begins in Wisconsin. You got the deer season starting on the 15th. Bear season starts on the 5th. You also have turkey and small game opening. Here in Nevada, you have all types of big game seasons that started in August and run through January. It's going to be going on the archery as well as rifle. And as I said, dove season does start today. Now, this brings us to the holiday season, the first Thanksgiving, in which we give thanks to God for all that we have this year. Maybe we'll even be thankful for a new president. Hopefully, we'll be rid of this tin-horned communist dictator that currently occupies the White House. And finally, we come to Christmas when we celebrate the birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Now, remember, our Constitution and this nation is built on Judeo-Christian beliefs. We're a Christian nation. Make no mistake about it. No matter what people in the press or what the liberal press say and what the current occupant of the White House may say, this is not a Muslim nation. We're a Christian nation. Don't forget it. So starts the sacred time of year, the season of the hunt, the season of the harvest. I hope you have a great season filled with family and friends. Now, we've got something that's going to be starting up, and I want you to take a look at our website. I know Daryl talked about a lot about this. You can go to Rural Nevada Today. What we're going to be doing, anybody who submits a photo to the game board, it doesn't have to be big game. It can be a dove hunt, a pheasant hunt, whatever. But anybody who brings a photo to send in to the game board, Fishing Tales, Wall of Heroes, or if you got a recipe, I put on some new recipes. You got about 8 new recipes that we typed in that you can follow. They're not the movie. They're just the tapes. What we're going to do, we're going to start that this week. Anybody who submits a recipe by or photo by Thursday, you're going to be put into a drawing, and that Saturday we'll draw your name. We'll let you know who you are. You'll also be contacted online. But what we'll do, and we're going to do this for the next 5 weeks from now until October 6th, you're going to get 4 tickets to the mob attraction. Each week, you're going to have a different winner. Now, it's, like I say, to qualify, you got to put this in by Thursday, and it'll qualify you for that following Saturday. Last time you're going to be able to put in is October 4th, but you got all of that going on. Should be a lot of great fun. It's going to be a great season. Now, Packer fans, this is the time of year when we pray for the strength of Aaron Rodgers' arms and a defense to match our offense. Now, last season with 15 regular season wins was the best season on record for the Packers, the best they ever had. Hopefully, they'll get another shot at the Super Bowl this season. Now, here's the thing. Odds for the Packers winning the Super Bowl this year are 11-2, so it comes out to 5.5-1. Patriots are the only team that the book rates higher. The Patriots are at 5-1. Now, the season starts Sunday on the 9th of September. Packers are going to be 2 great games back-to-back. Packers are going to be hosting the 49ers in Green Bay. That game is going to be followed by a Thursday night game. Packers are going to be hosting the Chicago Bears. Doesn't get any better than that. A Packers-Bears game incredible. So enjoy the season. And hey, how about Mitt Romney's pick? Paul Ryan has the VP. Romney has consolidated the conservatives behind him. Many conservatives, myself included, have been lukewarm about a Romney presidency. But with the combination of Ryan and the calls for the GOP for broader gun rights, a Romney presidency is really looking like a winner. Then again, you know, what was our choice with the current occupant of the House, White House? We didn't really have a choice. An Obama second term would implement health care and would turn this nation into a third world nation. Remember, Obama stated, and we had it on the program, we ran this tape, Obama stated that he would bring our military level down to a level that was acceptable to our Muslim brothers. I don't know about you, but I'll tell you what, I don't have any Muslim brothers. This man hates this nation, and he wants to destroy it. Make no mistake about it. Now, with the choice of Paul Ryan, it changes the game. With Ryan, we get to be assured of real welfare reform, and that budget cuts will not only be addressed, but they'll also be handled. Ryan will make a great vice president. When the time comes, he'll be an even a greater president. Now, Ryan appeals to Republicans and independents alike. He is the brightest of all of the Republicans in Congress. And even though he's youthful, he carries a Reagan-esque quality about him. Our nation will be well served by a Romney-Ryan ticket. And then how about old Uncle Harry? Is this guy getting goofier by the day or what? He was shameless, even by his standards, for criticizing Mitt Romney and Paul Ryan for visiting New Orleans to visit firsthand the damage that was done by Hurricane Isaac. Remember, the current occupant of the White House, this was absolutely beautiful. Now, he was scheduled to go to Texas, but when he heard that Romney was going to New Orleans, he changed his plan, and he is also going to New Orleans. Well, today we've got more on Uncle Harry. He's trying to stop a coal mine in northern Nevada, and what he wants out of the deal is more wilderness. You're not going to believe this one. We also, my wife's here in the studio today, and we're going to be joined by Danny Nelson of Sportsman's Warehouse. We got a field test on a PSE bow, and we're going to talk about it today. But in about 5-6 weeks, we're going to have film footage of Angel actually shooting the bow and showing you everything about it. That interview is going to come right after the 6:30 break. Now, I'd also like to hear today what you think about the GOP convention this morning. And if you got any questions when Danny's on, please limit it to your bow questions. Now, you can give us a call at 702-257-KDWN. That number again is 702-257-5396. Now it's time for the Gold Silver Live Market Commodities Report at the close of business on Friday, August 31st, 2012. Gold closed for $1,694 an ounce. It's gone up almost $100 an ounce since mid-July. Not a good indicator for the dollar. Now, silver closed at $31.88 an ounce. And this week's report was brought to us by Round Mountain Gold.
What can a gold mine do for a county's economy? Round Mountain Gold, a joint venture with Kinross Gold Corporation located in northern Nye County, has been helping the people of Nye County and the state of Nevada for years. Today, Round Mountain Gold employs close to 800 people and is the largest private taxpayer in Nye County. Round Mountain is dedicated to preserving the mining tradition and creating jobs in mining for generations to come. If you're interested in pursuing a career in mining, call 775-377-3137. That's 775-377-3137. Interested in seeing modern gold mining at work? Then call 775-377-3169 for a tour. Or go to nevadamining.org to learn more about what mining does for Nevada.
Well, welcome back to the show. And I guess we're going to start with a caller. Caller, you're on the air. How you doing today?
Hello?
Go ahead, caller. How you doing?
Peter, can you hear me?
Yeah, I sure can hear you.
Hey, this is Rashawn. Happy anniversary.
Hey,
buddy.
Thanks a lot, buddy.
Hey, I'm in the field dove hunting.
Where you hunting at?
I'm out by Bunkerville.
Cool.
We just now started seeing some birds. My buddy, Alan, who's a first-time hunter, just got his first dove about 5 minutes ago.
Cool.
I've seen
somebody just shot.
Yeah, he made a great shot. You know, and there was one in the distance. It's been a beautiful morning, but it's kind of slow, though.
It is kind of slow. Okay, it was a long time ago. Daryl and I, and a whole group, Jay Ashworth, we'd all went out, and we hunted in Mesquite.
Remember, Senator Lee came with you.
Yeah, and John Lee, and we all limited out. It was a great hunt. Now, I'll tell you what, you're the first guy to call in with a hunting report, so you get your choice. You can get a topographical map from Desert Outfitters, or you get a pocket knife from Rebuilt Radiator. What's your choice?
I think I'll go see Daryl and get the pocket knife.
You got it.
Peter?
Yeah.
I'd like to also say good morning to my good buddy Mike Oberlin, who's listening to your show.
Yeah.
And Clarence Rose. These guys, they really love your show, and they listen to you, and we've been waiting to have you back, you know, so it's good to hear you again.
It's great to be back, and just in time for the 14th anniversary, so don't get any better than that.
All right, we'll talk at you later, Peter.
Yeah, hey, Rashad, you have a great hunt today. You take
all
care
righty,
of it.
All thank you.
You got
Bye.
It. All right. Okay, so we still got a topographical map for anybody who's out there hunting. You want to call in, say, hey, I'm hunting, give me a report, I want to know. But it is time for the contest, so give us a call at 702-257-5396. That number again is 702-257-5396. Now, it's the 14th anniversary. I want to know for the old fans. 14 years ago today, I went on the air, I had four sponsors. One of those sponsors still advertises on this show today, 14 years later. I want to know who that sponsor is. Give me a call at 702-257-5396. We'll be back with your calls right after the break.
Nestled on the Nevada-California border in the Sandy Valley sits Two Hawk Ranch. Surrounded by thick, lush fields of locally grown alfalfa, Two Hawk Ranch has bulk and cubes available. If you have not tried alfalfa cubes, let the good folks at Two Hawk Ranch explain to you the value of feeding your horses cubes, and you decide which of these great products you wish to feed your animal. Horse and livestock owners, with a great supply of locally grown alfalfa, where you can buy direct from the owner. Why would you buy from anyone else? Call Jared or Kale at 702-723-5375. That number again, 702-723-5375. Or drive out the Sandy Valley and follow the signs. You'll be able to see the green fields of Two Hawk Ranch long before you get there. Two Hawk Ranch, they'll always treat you right.
Jumping on a trampoline can leave you thirsty, but most drinks out there are high in calories and low in vitamins and minerals and lack a very important thing. The power behind the play. Milk from your local dairyman gives you that power. Low-fat and fat-free milk are naturally nutrient-rich, keeping you healthy and fit. So after all that jumping, ask for quality, icy-cold local milk from your local dairyman. It's the power behind the play. Scoring touchdowns can leave you thirsty, but most drinks out there are high in calories and low in vitamins and minerals and lack a very important thing. The power behind the play. Milk from your local dairyman gives you that power. Low-fat and fat-free milk are naturally nutrient-rich, keeping you healthy and fit. So after the big touchdown, ask for quality, icy-cold local milk from your local dairyman. It's the power behind the play. Visit DairyCouncilUTNB.org.
The phone lines are open. Call Peter now at 702-257-5396.
Well, welcome back to the show. What I'm looking for is September 1st, on a Saturday in 1998, I started on the radio with four sponsors. One of those sponsors is still advertising with me today. I want to know who that sponsor was. Give us a call at 702-257-5396. And we have a caller. Caller, you're on the air.
Cool Radiator?
No, they weren't. Cool Radiator actually was introduced to me by the person who is still advertising with us today. Cool Radiator started back in February of 1999 when I finally came on KDWN.
Okay.
Hey, thanks for the call and have a great day.
Thank you.
You're welcome. So what we're looking for is I need to know who, we didn't get that right. I want to know who the advertiser was, who was advertising with me on my first show and is still advertising with me today. I'll tell you what, we got a fishing report. Now, at Lake Mead, Fishing continues to be good for stripers and anglers who have found boils in the Colville area. Now, monsoonal rains have dropped a lot of water into the lake, and the runoff has caused the water to become a little bit murky. Keep an eye out for floating debris if you're out there. Now we got another caller. Caller, you're on the air. How you doing today?
Would that be Round Mountain Gold?
No, Round Mountain Gold's been with us for a long time, but they've only been on the air for 5 years.
Okay.
Hey, thanks, and have a great day.
You too.
Once again, we need somebody to call in and give me the name of the sponsor who's advertising today that was on the original show September 1st, 1998. Give us a call at 257-5396. Now, out at Lake Mojave, the area around Cottonwood Cove continues to provide good action for catfish along with large and smallmouth bass. Now, a few stripers have been taken over the past week, even though their conditions have been good with slight wind changes and cooling temperatures associated with the monsoonal rains. Down in Laughlin Lagoon has produced this week some large, close to a state record. They caught a bluegill. Are you ready for this? They caught a bluegill on a nightcrawler. According to Rusty at the Riviera Marina, a young angler hauled in a bluegill weighing 3.68 pounds. That is a monster, and it measured 15 7/8 inch, almost 16 inches long. He was fishing with his mother. Congratulations for her for taking him out. And our stripe reaction has picked up near the Big Bend and below Davis Dam. Fish are ranging in the 3 to 5 pound area range. Now, in the area ponds, Endow Planet, their catfish back in on the 22nd of August at Floyd Lamb, Sunset, Veterans Memorial, and Boulder City and Hafen Park in Mesquite. Now, anglers have been catching a few bluegill along with catfish. Don't forget, in these urban areas, you can only catch three fish, and don't practice catch and release. These people who do this catch and release, and then they're sitting there, and they've got all kinds of dead fish floating in front of them. Trout and a lot of these smaller fish don't work out real good with catch and release. You got three fish. When you catch them, take them home. Now, out of Kirsch Wildlife Management Area in Nye County, most current reports indicate that anglers are still battling with weeds, but they're catching largemouth bass though the fishing activity has been slow. Now, trout fishing has been slow. It's because of the weather. When it starts to cool off, and it's going to be coming within the next month or so, your trout will start to pick up. Now, if you're heading up into Lincoln County this weekend, Eagle Valley Reservoir, anglers are using night crawlers, mini marshmallows. They're finding good action for fish in the 13 to 15-inch range. They're also catching a few browns. Now, power bait are coming in second for hooking up rainbow. Now, they're saying a 2.5-pound largemouth bass was taken from the lake this week. Water level has raised recently because of the rain. You know, there's also has caused the water to be a little bit murky due to the runoff. Now, to your sister reservoir, if you want to go over to Echo Canyon, fishing continues to remain good for rainbow, crappie, and largemouth bass. Anglers have found success using power baits, night crawlers, mini marshmallows. Now, fly casters have been doing well with woolly boogers and gold-headed beads. The lake level has raised due to the monsoonal rains. The water's a little bit murky because of that runoff. Now, once again, I am looking. We still have not got this trivia question. I want to know, when I started the show, my first show, I had four sponsors on the show. Tell me the one sponsor out of those four that is still advertising with us. Give me a call at 257-5396. That number again is 257-5396. This week's Fishing Report was brought to us by Cool Radiator.
It's a great time of the year to check out your car or truck and make sure it's running to get the best gas mileage or to make sure it's ready for that long road trip. The question is, who can you trust to do the job right? Well, how about taking it to the guy we've been talking about for the last 14 years? That's Daryl at Cool Radiator. Cool Radiator at 3228 West Mead Avenue can take care of all your automotive needs, from that tune-up to oil changes to that radiator job that you've been putting off. Well, now's the time to call Daryl at Cool Radiator at 362-1964. That number again is 362-1964. Or just stop by and see Daryl at 3228 West Mead Avenue. And as always, Hunting and Fishing Talk is welcomed. Campers, stop by and see all of Daryl's enamel and cast iron cookware. That's Daryl at Cool Radiator at 3228 West Mead Avenue.
Well, welcome back to the show. Now, once again, I want to know, we still have not got this correct on who the sponsor is, was on the original show, September 1998. Now, what you're playing for here is you're going to get a $25 gift certificate to Off the Strip. You can go in and eat dinner, whatever you have. It's going to be great. Now, Bird Hunters, tell you what, they have got a new water development atlas that has been come out by the Department of Wildlife. Back in the mid-'80s, they began printing these small publications that included maps showing where those water developments are. All of you know these as guzzlers. And, you know, guzzlers, they're metal fiberglass structures that are built suitable for habitat. They collect rainwater. They collect all kinds of water. Now, we got a caller. Caller, you're on the air.
Yes, I'd like to take a shot at it.
You got it.
How about the dairy?
No, the dairy came on 5 years ago when we put together Round Mountain Gold.
Oh, rats. Okay.
Hey, thanks for calling. Have a great day.
Bye-bye.
All right, we still need to know. You're going to get a $25 gift certificate Off the Strip. Who was that sponsor who's on? He's still on the show, and he was on with us on the original show. Give us a call at 257-5396. Okay, so now as this thing developed, you had in the 90s, the book was brought back for a statewide publication. It was 68 pages, black and white maps with the locations of all of these water developments. Now this year, the Department of Wildlife went back to the drawing board. They completely redesigned this, and you can go in and you can buy this. They've got it available in the Department of Wildlife offices, and you get it for $50 at your nearest office. And we got some callers. Caller line one, you're on the air.
Yeah, was it the mining company?
That's what?
The mining company?
No, Round Mountain Gold started with us about 5 years ago.
Thank you.
Hey, thanks a lot. Thanks for the call. Okay, once again, folks, I need to know who the sponsor is. And you'll be playing for a $25 gift certificate to Off the Strip. It's a sponsor that's on today. And they originally were on my very first show. Now, when we come back from the show, we're going to have Danny Nelson from Sportsman's Warehouse. We got a product review. I've got my wife here in the studio. We picked up a Chaos Bow, and we're going to check this out and see what happened. And we'll talk to you about this. It's a great bow, and you'll get to find out all about it. You get to find out about it from my wife as well as from Danny. And I'll tell you why we picked it. Okay. Caller line one, you're on the air.
Okay. I'm thinking that it's Desert Outfitters.
Who is it?
Desert Outfitters.
No, but, you know, Desert Outfitters, now he's another one. He came on about the same time as Cole Radiator. Desert Outfit has been with me since, like, April or May of 99.
Well, that's loyalty, let me tell you.
That's the whole thing. This is why this question is so hard. Most of these guys have been around for 10 more or more years.
Yeah.
Okay, well, thanks a lot for the call, and you have a great day. Well, you know what? It's that time. I got to take a break, but give us a call if you know that question. Give us a call at 702-257-5396. We'll be back right after this.
Eagles fans, looking for a great place for gaming as well as watching all the games? A place where you have daily football parlay cards and gambler's bonus? Then stop by Off the Strip on Tropicana just west of Grand Canyon. Off the Strip has all kinds of football specials, including $2.50 domestic draft beer, 10 food items for under $10, and special game fare. So if you're looking for a place that is a step above the rest, then stop by Off the Strip at 9837 West Tropicana. Then you and the Eagles will both have a great season.
I like baseball. I love milk. My milk's low in calories and high in vitamins and minerals. My milk comes from cows in beautiful Nevada. Cows and milk are the power behind the play.
Icy cold local milk from your local dairyman gives you that power. Low fat and fat free milk are naturally nutrient rich.
Baseball and milk keep me healthy and fit.
Quality, icy cold local milk from your local dairyman.
The power behind the play.
There's nothing like going hunting, whether it's a big game hunt of a lifetime or just a local bird hunt with close friends. Hunts never last as long as you want them to, and when the hunt is over, the only thing that's left is the memory of that hunt. So to preserve those memories, you mount your game, and every time you look at that mount, it takes you back to that hunt, and you remember every detail of it. That's why, with all the time and effort that you put into your hunt and getting that trophy, you deserve the best taxidermy possible. Here in Southern Nevada, that means Scott at Great Basin Taxidermy. Scott can do head and shoulder mounts, rugs, full body mounts, mounts in natural habitat. He also does birds, fish, and small game mounts. So when you need a taxidermist, call Scott at Great Basin Taxidermy. That's 368-1848. That number again is 368-1848. That's Great Basin Taxidermy at 3894 West Spring Mountain Road. Great Basin Taxidermy, creating hunting memories in Southern Nevada since 1988.
I like basketball. I love milk. My milk's low in calories and high in vitamins and minerals. My milk comes from cows in beautiful Nevada. Cows and milk are the power behind the play.
Icy cold local milk from your local dairyman gives you that power. Low-fat and fat-free milk are naturally nutrient-rich.
Basketball and milk keep me healthy and fit.
Quality, icy cold local milk from your local dairyman.
The power behind the play.
Well, welcome back to the show. I'll tell you what, we've got a couple of callers, and then we're going to get to Danny. Go ahead, caller line one. How you doing today?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing great.
Hey, I sure did miss you the last few weeks.
Well, I'm back.
I know. No, and Daryl's a pretty good host, too. I really enjoyed him.
Wonderful.
Hey, I think my guess is going to be the Great Basin Taxidermy.
I'll tell you what, that's exactly right. It, you know, he was on, we had four sponsors. We had the main sponsor was Hidden Valley, and then you had Great Basin Taxidermy, Bedrock Landscaping, and you had Hans Military Surplus. Those were the first four. And the whole thing is, you know, it's like Jim and I were talking over the break. A lot of these guys have been with me for 10 years or more, so it makes it really hard. But if you would hold on, please give Jim your name and address, and we'll get that certificate mailed out to you, okay?
All right.
Hey, thanks, and have a great day.
You too, Peter.
Have a wonderful day, sir. Okay, and then we've got Danny. Danny, how you doing this morning? Danny?
Yep.
Hey, how you doing? This is Danny from Sportsman's Warehouse. And
Sportsman's Warehouse.
Yep, and I wanted to set up a little bit and explain why I got the bow for Angel that I did. I picked a PSE Chaos Full Cam. Now, these are some neat bows, and they've changed some laws about archery, and it's because of the new bows that they've developed. The bow that I picked, it weighs 3.2 pounds. I picked a 50-pound pull bow, which is far more than my wife can pull back. But the reason why I picked it, it's the full cam. So you can dial it down from 30 pounds all the way up to 50. Now, what I found out in Wisconsin for their archery season, they have now lowered the law down to a 30-pound bow is legal to hunt deer. And with these new bow that they have, they use an arrow that is smaller in diameter than, like when I start, I use the old aluminum game catchers. I think you could fit this arrow inside my game catcher.
Right.
And it's a powerful little bow. Danny, you set the bow up for my wife, and you took her, you sighted it in. What were your thoughts on the bow?
I think it's a great bow. Like you said, it has a lot of adjustability. So for somebody who's new, you can set it up at a low draw weight, and then they can work their way up to a higher draw weight if they are inclined to. So if they intend on only shooting short distance, maybe back east hunting, you come to Nevada, most of your shots are going to be 40, 50 yards at least. You can get it up to that point. So for that reason, it's a great bow to get started with.
And I know she likes it. I want to ask, Angel, what are you thinking about? You were the one who we got the bow for. How do you feel? Are you comfortable with that? Or
the bow?
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
It's set up really easy. Sometimes when you're tuning the bow, you can spend 2-3 hours getting it set up. Over at the store, we really don't like setting the bow away that isn't 110%. And that bow, I had no problem. Took me maybe an hour and a half to get dialed in, paper tuned, a sight set. So when she goes out to the range, that pin should be pretty well set at 20 yards.
Yeah, so now the first pin, did you set the second two?
I'm sorry?
Did you set the second two pins?
We did, but it's not a perfect
She's going to have to practice
pin
a little
setting
bit.
Until you actually shoot at the longer distances.
Right.
Because the pins typically are set at 10-yard increments.
Right.
We get it close. I have a chronograph, and I shoot the arrow through the chronograph and wave the arrow so that I have an idea of how much drop it will have.
Okay.
And the rest is kind of just experience, trial and error, guesstimation of where to put them.
Right. Now, what did you set the bow weight on?
I'm sorry?
How many pounds did you set the bow at?
I believe we set it at about 35 pounds.
At 35? Okay, but she's not having any problems. Angela, how do you feel when you're pulling the bow back?
Stronger. The bow is awesome. It's light. It's accurate. And he did a wonderful job helping me and his helper. Don't forget his helper, Katrina.
Yeah.
She took me in the back room and, we did the test on it. It's wonderful.
Right. But she's going to be up in Wisconsin in about a month or so and, take a look at trying to get a white-tailed deer or a turkey with that. So she's going to have to tune it up a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
But you did a great job, Dan. I know Angel was real happy. And
thank you.
She was walking around and she's got
practicing.
Her her release and she's pulling back the string. The 35 pounds seems to be good. Now, I talked to my cousin and this is such a great thing. This is going to be the first year his whole family's going out archery hunting. Now, he's got a son, 14, and he's got an 11-year-old who's also going out there with a bow this year. They've got a youth hunt going on in Wisconsin, so he's going to be doing the youth hunt archery. So, and he's got one of the little bows and set up and see what's going on. Now, Danny, besides being with Sportsman's Warehouse, you're associated with another group, aren't you?
I also run the archery range up at the Clark County Shooting Complex.
And that'd be a great place
Wonderful.
To go, and get up there and get a chance to do some shooting and what have you. Angel, do you have any questions or any comments that you want to make?
Let's go hunting. I'm ready.
That sounds good to me.
I'm ready.
I got to step up and get a target from you, Danny.
Know where to find me.
Yeah, I do. I sure do. And I want to say something. It's not just. I didn't just pick Danny out of the blue. I didn't go to the phone book and say, okay, who's an archery expert? And look under archery expert in the phone book. I've been in the Sportsman's Warehouse several times. I got a problem. I'm going into debt because I can't keep my wife out of Sportsman's Warehouse. But, from the first time I met you, we talked, told you about the show and that. And I got to tell you, the products, your return policy, and the service. I know a lot of people, when they go into the super sports stores, they don't get good information. They don't always come out with good products. I've never had that problem at Sportsman's Warehouse. Whether it be you, somebody else, the service that I've gotten there, and it is what's so important. It's nice to look at all the animals. It's nice to look at all of the gear and go, wow. But if you don't have somebody there to talk to, It really makes a difference. So, Danny, we got to get going, but where is Sportsman's Warehouse? I'm going to let you give out the address and tell the folks how to get up there.
We are right off of the 95 at Ann, just to the west side of the highway. And the actual street address, I believe, you put me on the spot there.
Well, don't worry about that. You get into the plaza, they can't miss you.
56, I think it's definitely Centennial Center Drive.
Okay.
Everybody knows it as being in the Fresh and Easy and Yogurtland mm-hmm. shopping center. because that's the first thing you can see.
Well, great. Danny, I want to thank
you. We're open from Monday through Saturday, 9 a.m. to 9 p.m., and then Sundays, 10 to 6.
Okay. All right, well, I want to thank you so much for coming on the show this morning, but more importantly, I do want to thank you for setting up Angel's Ball.
Not a problem.
All right, glad
to help.
I'll see you sometime this week. There's a couple of things, obviously, we need. Okay?
You got it.
Danny, thanks, and have a great day.
You too.
Take care now.
Bye,
Al. Okay, we're going to have to go to break. When we come back from break, we have got more on Uncle Harry. This time, he's out destroying jobs all over Nevada. We'll be back right after this.
Jumping on a trampoline can leave you thirsty, but most drinks out there are high in calories and low in vitamins and minerals and lack a very important thing. The power behind the play. Milk from your local dairyman gives you that power. Low-fat and fat-free milk are naturally nutrient-rich, keeping you healthy and fit. So after all that jumping, ask for quality, icy-cold local milk from your local dairyman. It's the power behind the play. Visit DairyCouncilUTNV.org.
What can a gold mine do for a county's economy? Round Mountain Gold, a joint venture with Kinross Gold Corporation located in northern Nye County, has been helping the people of Nye County and the state of Nevada for years. Today, Round Mountain Gold employs close to 800 people and is the largest private taxpayer in Nye County. Round Mountain is dedicated to preserving the mining tradition and creating jobs in mining for generations to come. If you're interested in pursuing a career in mining, call 775-377-3137. That's 775-377-3137. Interested in seeing modern gold mining at work? Then call 775-377-3169 for a tour. Or go to nevadamining.org to learn more about what mining does for Nevada. If you want to advertise during this show, call Peter at 882-2865. That's 882-2865.
Well, welcome back to the show. You're listening to Rural Nevada Today right here on KDWN. Now, I got a topographical map to give away. If I got anybody who's out there hunting or has been out in the field, you want to call up and let me know what you're seeing, what your experience out there, you're going to get a topographical map. I want to talk about something, and this is an election year, folks. So I got on, and I know Daryl did a great job, and I was so happy because getting Daryl to talk about politics is like going to a dentist and having your teeth drilled on without Novocaine. It's something Daryl just doesn't want to do. He never does it, but go in, and he covered it great. He talked about how much he cared for this country. I want to get down to a practical thing. I am always talking about politics, but there's a reason for it. We have the highest unemployment in the entire country. We now have gone up to, I think we're only the 49th worst state in getting foreclosures, but we do lead in bankruptcy. I mean, we're leading in all of the wrong areas. Well, you got Mark Amadei, who's been on the show. He came on the show when he was running for Congress. He's been on the show when he was working for the mines. He's a great representative for mines. Mark's been on a couple of times. Now, he has been champion since he got elected in November of 2010, or actually got put into office last year. He's been trying to work on a simple bill that would create hundreds of high-paying jobs for people in northern Nevada. Now, it would allow the city of Arrington to purchase 90 square miles of property. And this, I got to tell you, this comes out of an editorial from the RJ. And I want to read this because they've got it right on the head. I want to congratulate the RJ on this. Now, they want to buy this 19 square miles from the Bureau of Land Management. Now, the land that surrounds the mine being developed by Nevada Copper, it's an enterprise that, when fully operational, it's going to employ 500 workers. It's 500 workers in Arrington. Annual average salary to 500 workers, $80,000 a year. Does that sound like it helps somebody's economy? I think so. The purchase would support business also in the mining town. A lot is going on here. But what's going on? Other plans that they're going to do, they're going to put a BMX track, they're going to put an outdoor amphitheater, a solar farm, a manufacturing district, all kinds of neat things that are going together. Now, it took an unnecessary amount of time to get it through the Republican-held House, but they did get it through. But now it's going through the Senate. And guess who steps in here? Old Uncle Harry. He's laying down his own conditions. It's like, Harry, wake up. Are you senile? Nevada, it's your state. We're trying to get jobs in here. But Uncle Harry says, hey, if you want me to okay and sign off on this project, I want more wilderness. Now, we got a 12% unemployment rate, and that's misleading. Because you have people who are well past the unemployment. They've gone through their unemployment. You got people who are self-employed who are underemployed. You got people who are self-employed who no longer have jobs. So they don't get counted. Our real unemployment rate here in Nevada is closer to 20%. Although Uncle Harry, you know, he wants the wilderness. Now, Uncle Harry, not only did he go criticize Romney and Ryan for stopping out to visit what happened with Hurricane Isaac, the man's gone completely senile. He says, it's not a lot of wilderness area, but it's something that's important. Who is it important to? Now, he says this to the Reno Gazette Journal last week after President Obama's campaign stop at the Truckee Meadows Community College. They cannot think that they're going to get this and not do something for the environment. Well, guess what, Harry? Have you checked out what the mines do in this state? How they've cleaned it up? How they've improved things for fishing and for wildlife? Harry? Why don't you wake up? The guy is out of his mind, but that's the Democratic Party. Now, when you come to vote, I want you to remember this. You got 500 jobs. These aren't these minimum wage jobs at McDonald's or at the Dairy Queen. These are $80,000 a year job. But then again, you know what? If a guy's making $80,000, he's probably a greedy, rich Republican who hates the environment and wants dirty water. What are you thinking, Uncle Harry? But Uncle Harry's the hatchet man for the current occupant of the White House. When you go to vote, folks, think about this. Remember this. You know, he says he's been good to mining. He's been in Washington for 30 years. And he talks about building a nearby solar farm isn't enough. Well, yeah, okay. So far, we're doing real well with solar farms, huh? How about Solyndra? But they're planning to build a solar farm. It's not enough. What Uncle Harry wants is 80,000 acres of wilderness. Now, let's see. What is 80,000 acres? It's hard to get a picture on, okay? Just for so we know the trade-off here, 80,000 acres of wilderness is 8 times the square miles that Arrington wants to buy. That is, folks, 150 square miles is what 80,000 acres is. Harry wants to put 180 square miles into wilderness. Now, you got to remember, federal land here in Nevada, over 86% of the land in Nevada belongs to the federal government. But we come into a situation where you've got a chance to bring in 500 jobs. Now, when you get 500 jobs, you get ancillary jobs to support those. They figure that there's about 6 jobs for every hard job. So 500 jobs, the ancillary jobs is another 3,000 jobs, 3,500 jobs in Urington. And the 500 mining jobs, the average annual salary is $80,000. But then you got the senile old man who is accusing Romney of being a felon, accusing him of causing somebody's wife's cancer. I heard there was a rape charge out there that floated around for a day or two. You know, you got all of this garbage that this senator, he should be ashamed of himself, Furthermore, I'll tell you what. The people who live in this state should be ashamed of themselves for voting this idiot in so many times. So when you come up to November, folks, stop and think. This is the future of this country. We're on an edge. And when you've got a guy who, you know, this isn't someplace in Kentucky that we're talking about. This isn't someplace up in Alaska. This is Reed's home state. So Reed's currently blocking 3,500 jobs, 500 of them at a mine that are going to average $80,000 a year. Now, when you're trying to make your electric bill, remember that. I want to mention that, too. Remember, how's your electric bill? Now, I've been talking about this for 2 years, but it came to fruition this past 2 months. How high is your electric bill, folks? And remember, it was Uncle Harry who killed the coal mine up in Ely that would have brought 250 jobs into Ely, and it would have lowered your rate. Now, you might look and you might say, hey, these are these rural areas. Why do I care? They directly affect your pocketbook. Everything, the building blocks for everything in our economy, everything that runs our nation comes from the rurals. Now, nobody really got excited about some coal mine opening up in Ely. Hey, it doesn't affect you. You're working at a casino on the strip. What do you care? How's that electric bill going for you, buddy? That's from old Uncle Harry. And now he wants to block 500 jobs, making $80,000 a year with another 3,000 ancillary jobs that will go to support service for that. People think when you go to vote. We got to wrap it up, and we'll be back right after this.
Scoring touchdowns can leave you thirsty, but most drinks out there are high in calories and low in vitamins and minerals and lack a very important thing. The power behind the play. Milk from your local dairyman gives you that power. Low-fat and fat-free milk are naturally nutrient-rich, keeping you healthy and fit. So after the big touchdown, ask for quality, icy-cold local milk from your local dairyman. It's the power behind the play. Visit DairyCouncilUTNV.org.
If you want to advertise during this show, call Peter at 882-2865. That's 882-2865.
Well, welcome back to the show. I just want to wrap it up, but a couple of things. I do want to congratulate the Republican Party on a great convention. And how about Clint Eastwood? What a great guy. One of the things I do want to mention, the GOP is calling for broader gun rights. They don't want more laws. They want to give people broader gun rights. They also want unlimited clips for semi-automatic weapons. This party is going in the right direction. I don't ever want to hear somebody calling into the show saying there's no difference between the two parties. There's a huge difference. And I'd also, you got about a minute left. I want to thank everybody for calling in. And, you know, a couple of the callers, they've been around for years. And it's just like how hard it was to get that question about my first sponsor being Great Basin Taxidermy. And why is that? Because most of the guys on my show, most of the advertisers, they've been here on an average of 10 years. And it's a show that it's worked. It's worked because of you, the people who listen to this show. And I want to thank you. Out of everything I've ever done in my life, there's nothing that's given me more pleasure and more joy, and it's been a bigger honor than hosting this radio show, whether it was Outdoor Adventures, whether it was one of the TV shows that was a spinoff from Outdoor Adventures, or this show that we've had now for almost 5 years, Rural Nevada Today. It has been a great honor, and to have you people tune in at 6 o'clock in the morning to listen to this show is absolutely incredible. And I do want to thank each and every one of you for allowing me into the house. Have a great week. We'll talk again next week.
Must be some kind of way out of here. Say the Joker to the thief. There's too much confusion. I can't get no relief. Businessman there, drink my wine. Plowman.